Hello and welcome back. In this video, we'll go over USA map with COVID data. So we'll start by preparing this data to make a map. And then we'll also make use of longitude and latitude data and merge that data with the COVID data that we have. And finally, we'll create geographic map representing number of cases in each state in USA. Let's read COVID data in C. It's a CSV file. And it has headers in the first row. So let's say true. So you can see C has 117,000 observations with 34 columns. So it includes ID of each patient, their tentative age group, sex, city, province, country, and so on. One of the columns is country, so I'm going to filter this data and only focus on United States. So we connect C to filter and say country is United States. So this is what we have now. So we have all the states within US. Let's find out how many cases are there in each state. We'll store that information in USA itself. So let's group by. In this data set, states are called province. And then connect this to summarize, where we'll store within count number of cases. We can also arrange everything in descending order for count. So if you look at USA, we have all the states and we have a count for each state. Based on the data when this was collected, New York was at top with 4,000 plus cases. We have data on COVID for each state. We also have data on latitudes and longitudes for each state. So we need to merge that information. If you look at S, we have this column called region for states. And everything is lowercase. But in USA, states are named as province. And you see the first word starts with the uppercase. First of all, we have to make sure that both are lowercase. So let's use USA dollar sign province and say to lower. So now if you look at USA, you'll see everything is lowercase. So now we can merge data and let's store this merged data in data. So first data set that we have is in S and second one is in USA. So you can think of the first one as X and second one as Y. And when we merge, so we have to make sure that the column in S matches with column in USA. So this column is called region here. So in S you can see states are regions. And for the second file, USA, it's called province. So if we look at data, we now see that we have the states, longitude, latitude, as well as counts. So now we can create a map. So we will use ggplot, and the data is data. So for fill, we can use count and then we can add next layer, polygon. And then if you run this, so it will give a US map, which is the default one, but we can make some improvements. For example, between the states, we can add some color. We can also use the coordinate underscore map, polyconic, so that it doesn't look stretched or compressed. So this is slightly better, but if you look at the color, it goes from light to dark in the opposite direction. So we have to fix that. So let's use a scale underscore fill underscore gradient. We can also try 2. So darker color is for New York and California and other states where the numbers are high, and lighter colors are for other states. Obviously, this is much better. But if you want to use a specific color, you could do low equals, let's say white, high equals, we can try red. So if you do not like the background, you can get rid of that. Theme underscore white. We can also add a title. So this gives us a cleaner background. In the next video, we'll look at USA map for each county.